All right, one more time. Going. There's no way I actually burned through that much LP already. You're up on... Do Arkstones not recover LP? They should. Pretty sure they do. Taking LP damage. Do they really not restore LP? Am I really that screwed? Thank you. Okay, then. Why did you elect to not combo? That hasn't happened in a long time. Basically a free turn there. Patronize me. I'm doing fine. Okay, what are you gonna do? Tone mode. Still fine, so I'm just gonna keep going in. Oh. Psycho Whisper is basically fading here. Well, that's not what I expected. Fantastic. Back up, I need you comboing. Thank you. Now what? We're going to see tree mode? No? Maybe later. So ouch. Oh, that's tough. Combo with Heaven's Thunder, that would actually be really good. What is this gonna do? Fantastic. That was mid-turn in response to an attack, so that must be something good. He's going back to Toon. Okay. Does that mean that default mode is just beaten? Be a good round too. Stop quaking. Don't like that. You're going to kill my Jimmy. Already has no hope of making it to the end of this fight, but stop star quaking. So bad. You were done with normal. Is it not attacking? There's no way I'm faster than it. Oh, this is tree mode. I hope you don't use that frequently. It was just a stroke of bad luck. That's Berserk, I think. Thank you. you're missing stuff because you got slain, for lack of a better way to put it. Something I was expecting to encounter as a problem. Will you let me? Stop just spamming the absolute worst thing you have. It's very frustrating. So far behind on ever being able to... Well, Jenny's dead. Never mind. This is over. Wait. It's an instant game over if she dies? That screws everything. It means you need to make room for something else. I guess you can get rid of that. So you have to have a dead stone, or it's not going to be possible. I guess, yeah, you can have that then. Yeah, that doesn't restore LP. What in the ever-loving everything would make them think that was okay? They don't. They absolutely do not. I already used one before the last time I saved, and I don't have full LP. This is terrible. Now I know why they give you so many of them. They don't help with the most important thing, and there's nothing that does. I'm giving this one more try. If it doesn't work, I'm calling it a night and trying again some other time. Example of a game that could have been a lot better than it is, but the ending is horrible. I'm gonna have to. If this doesn't work, I'm gonna have to try again getting up through to this point with less LP lost and with tree gone instead of stone. Because stone is way easier to accommodate for. I think I can force this to work, just as long as Ginny and Gustav don't die. That's what's important. the main thing that's kind of miffing about it is I was kind of going, like, going through the dungeon itself, assuming that I could just use one of my arc stones and be back to full, but I can't do that. It doesn't fix the one thing that most needs fixed. Save I have that can even do anything other than start the final dungeon is way back at the time that I established what the districts would be for Han Nova, which is 8 hours in compared to 30. Somewhat okay, like, I do feel like I have the tools I need to win at this, like, point of the game. It's just annoying that, like, particular layer of work I would need to go to. To get a turtle killer in there once the first couple buffs are up. Oof. Now that she doesn't have the crystal boots, she takes a lot more damage, but it's either that or she has the, doesn't have the dead stone, and then she just dies and it's instant game over. But the main reason that's okay is because getting knocked down doesn't lose you any LP. phase change probably to tone.
Yeah.
Now can I please get a single turtle killer on? It would be so much better if I could have had access to more dead stones. But because I don't, it's basically a matter of who is most expendable and who can I, you know, pinch the fight out without. Still gonna eat the heaven's thunder. No? Okay then. Yeah, Psycho Whisper is basically Fatal Mirror. Except you don't keep pounding on them after you toss them into the dirt. So apparently if you get a combo, it doesn't respect the whisper, it'll still combo the intended target. Something that's immune to whatever causes it. But this is either normal or tree. This tree does not have a unique sprite. I'm a fool for saying it, but so far everything is going smoothly, you know, relatively speaking. Thank you. Yep, we're trading. Now, it's really hard for me to do my proper combos against tree form because tree form is slower than my person I have set to act first. Because you set the acting order, well, you can. You can either have everybody go whenever possible, or you can set a manual acting order, and nobody will go until the person you have set to first goes. So I set the slowest person to go first in order to have an RNG-free control of when I'm executing my actions. But that doesn't work here because Tree is slower than her. Let's see. Bother with regenerating Gustav because its key attack will just slaughter him. And the hope, anyway, is that I could at least get Guard Beast up so that he can hard block it. But I don't know what to do with this phase. I really don't. I didn't know what to expect with it, so I took out ones that I knew were problematic, but this one is worse. So it's entirely likely that I have to do this again with a different set of people, well, a different set of forms removed, and hopefully more total LP. Both Ginny and Gustav are down, the fight is over. I just like to make sure that's that's a known quantity of what's going on. Because the other two can't life water. Actually, no. I can emergency pick someone up with Roberto.
Thank you.
really hope this means it's giving me a break from a forest. I'm guessing this can only be back to normal. I don't think she has a beast guardian upgrade. Right now I'm basically just hoping I still have all four up for the next time the tree comes out. And then I'm ready to just go in on damage and finish it. So first round I think went fairly well. Could have been better, but... Oh, that's horrible.
She's down. Oh, fantastic. Alright, we're going back to tree. Also, main phase is finished. If I can get through tree, I should be at final. We've got one LP left. Say, as long as you don't target Ginny a lot, we're good. I shouldn't have even thought that, apparently. Extremely precious, but I'm gonna have to use one of our LP. I'm doing a lot of holding my breath right now. Only worked in my favor that time. Should be in tree mode, but you haven't done anything in tree, so I guess you aren't? Final, it might be actual tree now. I think it's actual tree now. That's bad. I don't want tree. I was hoping tree just decided not to happen. Good condition. Stick to what works. Also, forget to use Turtle Slayer on the first round of Switch. That is also a good strategy. Okay. still standing. It's great. It's actually really great. Can't be confident that her Reviva is still active, so I really want to get a new one on. Now we're getting into this crap. I have to get a turtle killer in. There are a couple of regenerates that are gone. Oh, that was horrible. Don't know what else to say, Prim, but, they won't let you use that for your last LP. That's right, I can strike slash to help alleviate this form. I think I remember that far too late, but still standing. poison will take care of that, though. She's still alive, though. Not that I have the time to do anything about that, but she is alive. Stun. I've seen this specific thing be affected by stuns before. I know it can happen. Just go for power. I can't, because after this it's gonna be end phase. End phase is like, oh, so you thought you were doing attrition battle before. From what I understand. Which one? The forest one? Finally comboing with Firebird after all this time. Must have just been an order thing. She's most likely gonna be down before I can do anything to her. Berserk him, you can have the pain. Hopefully this ends the phase. That didn't do much at all, and didn't end the phase. The absolute worst thing about this entire fight, Ginny dying is an instant game over. She also has the lowest LP of anyone in an excruciatingly long attrition battle of pure LP battling. I don't understand. I can't do anything but constant, constant damage control here. I have not had a free action since this whole thing started. Other than, like, some piddly pot shots. If it was wrong for a second, it stays wrong forever. Don't go down. Thank you. End the phase, please. Really? be totally honest, at this point, I would rather be dealing with the attrition of the final phase. Easily. Why did I have to say that? Why did I say that? Now it is time to pray. There's nothing to do but continue piling on damage. He died from the poison. Why didn't that spill over from the... Well, I kind of can't not pick him up. I just hope I'm slower. If I'm not slower, the battle is over. If I heal before Xenocide, the fight is literally over. Okay, the fight is not literally over. Some combos, please give me some combos. Not her, she's down twice. To hell with you. Wait, that was good. HP is still fine. Can we get a triple? No. Fine. Strike slashes damage. That's all that's left. Thank you. Please hit him more. Gustav is so ridiculously close to not being able to survive that. Ginny can no longer be healed. Picked up, rather. Might have looked terrible, but that's what I wanted. See, here's the thing. Roberto might be invincible against this boss. Against this phase, rather. Or at least so close to equilibrium that we can last an incredibly long time and get a lot of thousands in. Until my weapon breaks. I've got like 18 more attacks in me, and then I lose. So just comes down to a simple question. has the math aligned. This is, like, extremely stressful. Star had like a very low chance to do LP damage. It's like I can't use anything else because he won't even out the damage. I suppose I could do it every other turn. Just depend on LP for healing and dedicate to something stronger for the remaining six. Yeah, that is a ton more damage. Mathed it. Roberto's a god. I'm still not totally sure who I'm going to use in Unlimited. It depends on... Do you happen to know if that game has, like, good, like, ability to recruit other main characters? I know that's, like, basically a staple, but it hasn't always necessarily been. Like, Frontier 1 was very spotty with who could and couldn't get which other characters. It's, it literally comes down to, if I can recruit Armic, I'll pick Laura. If I can't recruit Armic, I'll pick Armic. Okay, good. So Laura's definitely aesthetic preference. Hit it with the firebrand. Oh, the steel weapon. Nope. Of course, the thing that would eventually destroy the strongest anima in the world was steel. That was still really, really cool. There was a whole lot of BS in the final chapter, but you still have the tools to make it, you know. It definitely feels like, you know, I felt empowered to do something about everything that was going on. Like, even when I was getting totally ripped apart by the tree phase, I knew that if it came down to it, I could just try again and remove that instead of stone. Because petrify isn't good either, but I can deal with petrify a lot better than I can deal with immediate fatal damage on one person and really close on two others. The most important thing to take away is bows do crap damage, but they're really good. Bows have like 8 different hybrid arts, and they're all really good. Well, they're not all really good. Some of them are just, you know, bonus damage and stuff, but beast spells are god tier, and bow meshes really well with beast and things that work well with beast. So, like, the combo I had on him, I basically figured out pretty early on was something that I absolutely wanted to have together, because guard beast is amazing, regenerate is amazing, firebird is amazing. Sparkshot even is just fire, while Firebird is beast and fire. But Sparkshot is really good damage, as far as bow stuff is concerned. I don't really think there's anything that can do better. in terms of other bow skills. There's probably a hybrid that has better potential damage, but not one that would work with what I've done. Yeah. I kinda knew all along that either Gustav or Roberto would be able to cinch that fight for me. But Gustav, somewhere along the line, lost his really good defensiveness. Like, he just didn't stack up well against the last couple phases. While others he could just last on forever. Well, not forever, but really, really well. But yeah, Bow, Beast, and Fire. That is basically the truest anti-attrition you can hope for. Well, Stone 2, yes. I wish I could have gotten to the end to the final phase with more of my stuff together. Like, I had 3 people that were allowed to still be alive, and none of them really had any buffs. I feel like, with the way I had them at the end, I got to utilize everyone really well. And I think that's what's most important. Everyone did really important things the whole fight. And then Roberto just had exactly what he needed to cinch it at the end for me. For how remarkably stressful it was also extremely rewarding to have a setup that paid off. There are 100 things that I wish were better about it. Like, just a little bit less edge here and there, but just with regards to that fight. But like I said before, I just feel like I felt empowered to make the right decisions to make the fight work for me. You know, I had the information, I had the tools, and I had the means. And that was what set this really far apart from Destroyer. Because Destroyer, even at his weakest form, you just don't have the information unless you, like, completely accidentally stumble upon what's going on in that fight. Nah. Honestly, I really, really wonder if there wasn't, like, more nuance to the intended text that would hint that you would need that kind of stuff there that the translation just didn't cover or, you know, properly portray. It's like, even if it was subtle, it's really hard to, it's really hard to, like, portray nuance in a translation like that if you're just doing the words and not, you know, trying to interpret the stuff, you know. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. When I do RS3 remake, there's a lot on the table for how much of what went wrong there was just because of the translation being wonky. I noticed, I played the Mana Collection Trials of Mana thing. I started on a new file on that on my own time, and I noticed that there were a lot of things. It was particularly in Angela's opening that I tried on translation, and then the I tried on the fan translation, then the collection came out, so I tried it again because I didn't get very far in the file. I'm like, hey, there's an excuse to try it again. And I noticed that there was a lot more character and, like, meaning to the things that were happening that I didn't really understand from the fan translation. Like, they make it much more apparent how abusive Angela's mother is. And they hammer that point home really well when Angela first escapes, because, like, you know, she passes out in the snowfield and gets rescued by a mother and child. And then she gets up to leave to, like, get on her way and get out of there because she's being hunted and all. And she goes up to the mother and child, and the child is like, hey, mommy, can we play with the nice lady? And then she's like, no, she has better things to do. We can play over there. And then she just kind of goes quiet and walks away. And they make it a lot more clear that that was like a... she was realizing how messed up her upbringing really was. But, like, in the fan translation, none of that really clipped together as interconnected meaning, just because, you know, it was just words. But anyway, as for, you know, this game itself, I had a lot of fun just getting through the game. Like, even the rougher fights and segments, excluding the two final segments, everything that was challenging was fairly challenging. Like, I didn't feel like I was just hecked unless I did very specific things or was at a very specific amount of power or, you know, stuff like that. That was kind of, like, the feeling I had the whole game long, was just, I am well equipped to deal with what's presented to me. But, like, so the experience in and of itself was really good and clean, and it all just worked. I always felt weird because I felt like I didn't have any control over what was going on, because you never have the ability to, you know, just go do normal town stuff, except for very specific points when they allow you to exactly once. So it was like, I always felt like I was underprepared. I always felt like I didn't have enough time to, you know, do standard maintenance from event to event. But I always had what I needed. In fact, for a while, I had too much for quite a long time. Mostly because I couldn't just go sell stuff. I had to throw stuff away. But some of the things that were weird, like, there were a bunch of things that just didn't end up coming across as necessary at all. Like, chips? I never got to use chips. Not once. It wasn't until the very end that I got enough total chips for anything to appear in the crafty shop. And it was crap. It wasn't anything I needed. I went and looked up the list of the things you can make. Most of them require twice as much as I had. And I'm like, where the heck do these people have time to get that many chips? So that whole thing felt really weird and underutilized to an extreme. Weapon durability, to be entirely honest, it never really played a part in anything. Like, there were a couple times when I was left without a usable weapon for a reason other than I went in with one that was already low. That's just because they were very, very long fights. Granted, one of them was the final battle. I was down to the last 5 uses of my weapon before it was hard over. And that was the only thing stopping me from just infinite attrition counter. But, like, other than that, I never felt like I had to conserve or worry about my durability or really worry about times when you're allowed to restore the durability on things. Because I always had something else there to use. It's like, I was trying to compare it to, like, Legend 2. Because that was, I think, the most recent game before it that had the durability. And, like, you went through weapons so much more frequently in that, but you also had so much more access to getting new ones. So it felt like the concept of circulation was much more related to your ability to utilize your money and time well. When here it's just like, I'm getting so many weapons and so much random stuff that I need to keep throwing it away because I have this limited space and everything. But I guess that was it for things that really bothered me. Like, there were a couple of events where things happened off camera that probably should have been the things happening on camera, and vice versa. But that's more nitpicky and wasn't really that much of a detriment because I still got it. But yeah, I guess I'll stop rambling because we're done with the reel and the showcase of the things I've done and learned. I guess I got a C rank in chip acquisition. Okay. I don't really know where I was supposed to get so much more to get to an A or possibly something beyond an A, but I don't know, I've been over that. Anyway, I did have a whole lot of fun playing this game, honestly. just as an experience, it was really good. Early on, I had to let go and, like, stop feeling so constrained and, like, the railroad is taking me someplace bad. Like, I just had to accept that things happened and I didn't really have control over when or where they happened. Once I got past that, and I just kind of let things happen the way they were going to happen, it was really smooth and interesting and fun, and there was a lot of neat causality between the generations and everything, and I wish that Han Nova had been more of a thing. It's like, I did the one event where you set up what districts are in it, and I got to go there exactly once. It didn't have the only thing I cared about, and then it was gone. But anyway, overall, the game, as always, has incredible presentation and graphics and music and effects and everything. But even though, like, the final chapter was kind of a drag, there was like enough of a counterbalance of a triumph that it was actually not really a detriment to my opinion of it at all. Like, if I really had to go back and re-optimize and redo everything once again, probably wouldn't have been so good. But as it was presented and as I received it, it was good.